What's up, guys? Grim here. Have you heard the rumor? We are over 7,000 subscribers strong now. Thank you to everybody that's been supporting the channel and been spreading around my channel, to everybody that's been asking. Whenever your guildies or friends say, hey, how do I play Marksman? How do I play a Battle Bard or something? A lot of you guys are going, hey, go on YouTube and search for Grim Gaming Rift and check out his Battle Bard guide or Marksman guide or whatever. And that is huge. That is helping grow the channel so much. And currently we are the number one active Rift YouTube channel. And it's all thanks to you guys. Thank you so much. And let's keep this train rolling. On to the Tempest guide. What's up, guys? Today we're going to go over a Tempest PvP build because Tempest just recently got a little bit of a buff and everybody's going, Grim, make a Tempest build because we're wanting to see what would be viable in PvP. And since it's gotten buffed up a little bit, now we're looking at it again and seeing how viable it is and what we should run. So let's go right into it. All right, so let's go into the Soul build. And if you'd like to see this on a web page and not have to pause the video or squint at your screen, please refer to the description below and I will have a link down there where you can click on it, look at the build all you want without having to pause the video. I will also have all of the macros and all the K alerts and all that stuff down there. So be sure to refer down there because a lot of times I change the macros and all that. Well, I can't really change it in the video, so look down there and I'll have updated macros as much as I can and always use down there. All right, so the build here we have is 61 into Tempest, which Tempest is a premium soul. If you do not have this, you will need to go to the Rift store and buy the Storm Legion soul bundle because it has Tempest and a lot of other things like Defiler and a lot of good souls that you would want. And Tempest is the warrior version. So we went 61 into Tempest, 5 into Reaver, which we went 5 into Entropic Embrace, and then 10 into Riftblade, which we went 5 into Elemental Precision, 3 Elemental Empowerment, and 2 into Surging Energy. All right, so there's several reasons why we went with this particular build, because there are a lot of Tempest builds being run whenever people are actually running Tempest. They're mixing in things like Paragon, Void Knight. There's just a lot of different combinations that you can go with this. Even Champion if they're wanting extra energy saving abilities. So, yeah. The reason why we went with Riftblade is because, one, we get Avatar of the Wind, which is going to increase our movement speed by 10%. And we are in PvP with this build, so that is a huge increase there. Having any kind of movement speed increases in PvP is awesome, beyond awesome. Now, a lot of people will think that you need to go with a little bit higher of a DPS build or something. That's their preference, but I make my builds for PvP. They're not made to like put the absolute top DPS or something like that. They're meant to be viable in PvP. So yeah, the movement and speed increase right there. And also we pick up Flame Spear, which in between the burst abilities of Tempest, it kind of lacks in DPS. So having dots is going to increase your DPS quite a bit. And then the Reaver over here, we went with it to get Soul Sickness, which is going to give us a second dot. And then also so that we can pick up Binding of Affliction, which is going to increase our damage by 5%. Outside of the normal passives that we have putting points into. Alright, so these are completely PvP choices here. Not the top DPS or something like that that a PvE build will have. So keep that in mind, guys. I know a lot of people make comments, well, you could have got a little more DPS by doing this. No, I went with this for a reason. Alright, so the masteries that we went with is level 61, Resonating Strikes, 62 Steadfast Souls, 63 Runner's Training, 64 Ethereal Strikes, and level 65 Power Variation. Now, I went with the heal at level 65 because anybody that watched me knows that I gotta have some kind of heal. There is no worse feeling in PvP than getting low in life and being in combat and there's no way to heal yourself. And you basically have to wait until the enemy targets you and finishes you off. If you could be able to cast a heal, you could be right back into the fight and be much braver than having to run away, basically. So, yeah, heals are very important to me. However, with the Tempest build, it's a little bit of an iffy thing to pick the heal on because, like I said, the damage can be lacking at times. So, if you went with power manipulation instead, you would, of course, have a DPS increase, and that could help you out quite a bit. It's all your choice. If you go with power manipulation, you're going to be a big-time glass cannon. If you go with power variation, you're going to be able to heal yourself and be a little more durable in PvP, which I enjoy. The buffs that we got is Enhanced Conductivity, Empower, Focused Fire, Electromagnetic Shield, Avatar of the Wind, Storm Blade, and Binding of Affliction, and of course any Guild or Planar buffs that you might have. Alright, so let's go into the macros here. Now I have to put a disclaimer on the macros, as in they are built in a way to make it easier on you guys for PvP, because in PvE situations, naturally you will separate all of your buttons. I get criticized a lot for putting a lot of stuff in macros, but they are there for the main reason of making it simpler on PvP, also for people learning the build for the first time. Because whenever you're PvPing, having a lot of buttons is not very viable if you don't play the spec a lot. Now, if you're somebody that plays Tempest full-time, of course you're going to separate these things quite a bit. But if you're somebody just learning it, or else somebody that just switches the Tempest once in a long while, there's just no way you're going to be able to keep up with all kinds of buttons and run specific rotations and all that. So these macros are made to be easier on you. Also, it makes it to where you can PvP better, as in you can focus more on your movement rather than focusing on hitting certain buttons and all that. All right, so the first macro we have is basically our builder macro, and this is also going to cast our Storm Shield. If you cast it while moving, it's going to cast a lot of abilities, but if you stand still and cast it, it will go into a cast time ability, which is Charge Pulse. So keep that in mind whenever you're hitting that button. All right, then we have our Finisher macro, which is going to cast Arc and Skyfall. We have our Torrent macro, and then we have our Burst macro here, which is going to be our main cooldown ability. Alright, then we have our heal. If you did not pick up power variation, put power manipulation either in your spam button or either in your burst button, whichever you prefer, but I went with the heal, so this is the heal macro. Alright, then we have our dot macro, which is going to cast Flame Spear and Soul Sickness. Then we have a knockback macro, which is going to be an awesome macro, as in knocks everybody off the cliff kind of thing. It's very fun to play with this macro, trust me. On our bar down here, we have our builder macro, the finisher macro, burst macro, the torrent macro, our heal macro, our dot macro, light refraction, which is going to put us into stealth while we're standing still. We have elude, which is pretty much the best leap back in the game, which leaps back 20 meters and also removes all crowd control effects. We have break free on a separate button. Don't put it in your macros, guys. We have Distract and Pulse, which is our interrupt. I also recommend not putting in your macros, but do what you like. Disorienting Blast, which is going to stun up to 8 enemies. And then our knockback macro. Alright, so how to play this build is pretty simple. It's basically mostly movement based, except for whenever you're wanting to cast your Charge Pulse in your builder. Now, if we're going to go ahead and just hit our spam button, we're going to build up combo points until we have 3 combo points. Once we have that, we can hit our finisher, which is going to cast Arc. And Arc is an ability that it gives you, if you use it with 3 combo points, it'll give you 3 charges of Arc. And that makes it to where the next 3 attacking abilities is going to hit quite a bit harder. So we're going to go ahead and hit our finisher macro. And you'll see to the left, I have Arc, which is used with K-Alerts. And I'll have the K-Alert code down in the description below this video. It shows I have 3 charges of it. So if I stand still and hit my builder, it's going to cast my Charge Pulse. And you keep hitting it until it uses all of your arc charges, because there are abilities in there that will only fire off after a charge pulse is cast. So hit that builder macro, stand still, and it'll cast your charge pulse and use up your arc ability and, yeah, do a lot of damage. So that's our main builder finisher. The finisher does have Skyfall in it, which is a direct damage ability, but that will only be cast while Arc is on cooldown, because Arc has a 15 second cooldown. So naturally you're not going to be able to cast again. And also Charge Pulse has a cooldown. So yeah, you'll have to set up with Arc and then go into the Charge Pulse. So that's how the basic builder finisher rotation works on this. If you're moving while hitting your spam button, it's going to cast a lot of damaging abilities. If you stand still, it'll cast your harder hitting Charge Pulse, but of course that does have a cooldown. If you hit your finisher, it's going to put the three stacks of Arc onto you. If that is on cooldown, because that has a 15 second cooldown as well, then it will cast your Skyfall, which will be a direct damage ability. Alright, now we're going to get into the really fun part where we're going to be using our burst ability. Now this is going to be Wavelength, and it's basically once you pop it, you're going to get a 15 second window where you're going to be able to machine gun cast Charge Pulses out. It's going to make it to where they're not on a cast time anymore, so they'll be instant abilities. Also, there will be no cooldown for them, so you can cast them over and over and over. So let's go ahead and set it up with an Arc. As you can see to the left of my character, I have three stacks. And then we're going to start just hitting our burst button here. So here goes the machine gun shots of Charge Pulses. And look how much damage it's putting out. And it's a 15 second window. As you can see to the left of my character, I have it to where K-Alerts is showing me how long it'll last. And it's over. Yeah. So for 15 seconds, you're going to be able to cast Charge Pulses over and over and over. Now, the big thing about that is it's on a minute cooldown. So once you cast it, it's 1 minute afterwards that you're going to have to wait to do it again. But it's a 15 second ability, so it's going to last for 15 seconds. That means that 45 seconds afterwards, it's going to be available again, which is awesome. This ability is very good, but waiting around for the minute is kind of tough at times. All right, we've went over the builder, the finisher, the burst, and now we need to go over the abilities that you're going to be able to use kind of in between to make up the damage. One of the things that you're going to be doing is casting your dot macro, and this will help make up damage that Tempest is kind of lacking in between burst phases. So let's go ahead and hit that twice, and the first cast will put up our Flame Spear. And then our second cast will put Soul Sickness onto our target. And that'll make it to where we're going to do a lot more damage than we normally would have if we're just spamming Tempest abilities. Another macro you can hit is your Torrent macro. And normally you want to use this whenever you don't have any combo points. Say you've been attacking quite a bit and you just cast your Skyfall. You don't have Arc up and you've used all your combo points. So the first time that you hit your Torrent macro, it's going to do a cone-shaped attack in front of you and hit everybody, and it's going to generate combo points up. So let's pretend that we just casted Skyfall and didn't set up with Arc, because normally whenever we put Arc up, we want to cast a Charge Pulse or something. But let's say that we just used up our combo points with a Skyfall and we hit our Torrent macro. And as you can see, everybody's getting hit in front of me, and it builds up three combo points. The next time we hit it is going to cast Lightning Torrent onto our single target, and that'll build up combo points as well. So you're going to have two big abilities right there to build up combo points, and they do quite a bit of damage. All right, let's go over the other abilities. We, of course, have Elude here, which take, for instance, all of your enemies are over here. And you're shooting at them and you notice that somebody roots you or stuns you, and you see the team is advancing on you and about to kill you. You can hit your Elude and it'll make you leap back 20 meters, break all CC on you. That way you can turn around and retreat or whatever you need to do. And another ability here is Light Refraction. While we're standing still, we can go into stealth. And you can put any abilities on your stealth bar down here if you like. I tend to just use it to stand still, and then I'll click it off when I'm ready. Alright, so other things we have is the Interrupt, which is going to be Distracting Pulse. We have our Stun here, which is very important in PvP. It stuns 8 enemies. And then we have our Knockback. Use this often, guys. If you are in a Codex match or something else, knock people off the cliff. It is so useful. And the first ability in this macro hits multiple targets at once. So yeah, knock everybody off that cliff. Take advantage of the codex and you'll thank me later. Now that I've shown you guys exactly how to play this build for the most part, now it's time to show you how to do it in live action for the most part. I'm going to attack this dummy and I'll pretty much explain to you what I'm doing along the way. Alright, so we're going to target our enemy. We're going to start out with no combo points at all. The first thing we're going to do is put up our dots. We want our dots to be going, and then we can hit our spam button. Finisher, stand still since we got arc up. Go ahead and use our arc charges. Finisher again, and now we can go into our torrent to build up combo points. Alright, finisher. And then we can go into our torrent again if we'd like and do more damage. And then finisher. Alright, now we got arc up and we can go into our burst ability. So let's go ahead and burst down our target. And we're going to keep spamming this until our entire timer is up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Alright, it's done. Finisher. Now we can go into another charge pulse since our arc is up. Alright, so there you have it, guys. That's basically it. Builder finisher is the thing that you can always rely on. Once you get arc up, go ahead and go into your charge pulse. If you get arc up again, go ahead and go into your burst macro if you like. The burst macro can be used basically whenever you choose. You can even use it without arc. It's going to be a lot of damage. Arc just helps it out. But yeah, just pick and choose whenever you want to use certain things. That is kind of more of an optimal rotation that I just showed you, but you know, it's all up to situations in PvP. If you see somebody low but arc isn't available, hit your burst macro if you need to. You know, do whatever you need to do to bring the enemies down when you need it. All right. I hope you guys enjoyed this build video, and if you did, make sure to hit the thumbs up button. As usual, my name is Grim, and I'll see you next time.